Hello friends, welcome you all. Today we will start our second unit, that is aggregate. So from this unit we have to achieve our second course outcome, that is use of relevant aggregates for required concrete work. So let us see the what are the points which we have to discuss. The total weightage of this unit is 10 marks and we have to complete it in 6 hours. So first point we have to see is introduction to the aggregates, then requirements of good aggregate, then classification of aggregates, that is according to the source, then shape and size of aggregate, then impurities present in the aggregate and the effect of that impurities in the aggregate, that is on concrete, then the properties of fine aggregate, that is source, size, shape, texture, strength, bulking, okay, sieve analysis, bulk density, moisture content, then also the properties of coarse aggregate, and lastly the testing of aggregates. Okay, so let us see firstly introduction to the aggregates. Here we can see the some different types of aggregates. Okay, so what is mean by aggregate? Aggregate is defined as the material used for the manufacture of the mortar and concrete, such as sand, gravel, crushed stone, etc., we can call as aggregates. Okay, so aggregate is nothing but the crushed stone or sand or gravel. Okay, so we can use for it for mortar and concrete, manufacturing of mortar and concrete. So these aggregate give the body to the concrete, okay, and reduce the shrinkage and affect the economy. And this may be a natural one, manufactured or recycled one, but the mere fact that the aggregate occupies the 60 to 80% of the concrete mix. Okay, so these aggregates in particular mix of concrete are selected for their durability, strength, workability and ability to receive finishes. The study of the concrete is incomplete without the aggregate, without the study of the aggregate in depth. Okay, so let us see what are the requirements of the good aggregate. So first one, the aggregate should be a strong one. Okay, it should be strong enough and having the sufficient impact, crushing and abrasion strength. Okay, so it should not be break suddenly or crushed or wear out, so it should be strong enough. Second one, it should be durable one, so to resist the atmospheric variation or temperature effect. Okay, that is it should be a long durable. Next is it should be non-reactive type, so it can avoid the alkali aggregate reactions. Some aggregates are react with the alkalis present in the concrete, so we have to take care that the aggregate we have to select the such type of aggregate which should not react to the alkali. Okay, so it should be non-reactive type to avoid the alkali aggregate reaction. Next one, it should be a clean, that is free from organic and inorganic impurities. So organic, inorganic impurities means it should be free from dust or silt content. Okay, or some debris. Next, it should be a well graded and having a minimum voids. Okay, next, it should have a rough texture for a better bonding. We know if the aggregate having a smooth texture, it cannot bind with the concrete mix properly. Okay, so for that purpose the aggregate should have a rough texture for better bonding. Next, it should be absorb water more than, it should not be absorbed water more than 5% from added water to avoid the variation in water cement ratio. If the aggregates absorb the water more than 5%, it means it can be absorbed the water from the cement paste also. So then the concrete mix will be a harsh one. So to avoid this, we have to select the aggregate such way that it should not be absorb water more than 5%. Okay, Next is it should have an angular shape for a strong interlocking of verticillars. Okay, the shape of the aggregate should be an angular one. Okay, for interlocking purpose. So these all are the requirements of good aggregates, and it is a very important one. So next point is the classification of aggregates. Aggregates are generally classified into three, that is the according to the source, then according to the size of aggregate, and according to the shape of aggregate. So let us see the first, according to source. So according to source, first it is categorized as the natural aggregates, that is the aggregate are found in the natural sources like river basin, seabeds, slope deposits, that is for an example, that is gravel and sand, okay, which are found in the riverbed, that is a natural aggregate. Next is the crush rock aggregate. This aggregate is formed by the crushing the various rocks obtained from the quarries. Okay, that is the we are crushing this aggregate in machines, that is stone aggregates. Okay, example of this is stone aggregates. Next is the artificial aggregates. The aggregates are made up various waste materials like burnt clay, artificial cinders, okay, steel rivet, then iron ores. We can call it as a artificial aggregate, which are made up of waste materials. Okay, next is the recycled aggregates. These aggregates is manufactured by the crushing inert construction and demolition waste. Okay, means we are using these aggregate again. Okay, after the demolition of any structure. Here we can see this is the natural aggregate and this is the artificial or recycled aggregates. Okay, so next is the according to the size of aggregate. The according to size of aggregate, it is classified as firstly coarse aggregates. So what is mean by coarse aggregate? The aggregate having size particles more than 4.75 mm, okay, are called as coarse aggregate. Means the aggregate which having the size more than 4.75 mm, we can call it as coarse aggregate. Next is the fine aggregate, that is the aggregate having size of particle less than 4.75 mm. okay, here it is meter but it is mm. The aggregate having the size of particle less than 4.75 mm are called as fine aggregate. And next is the all-in aggregate, that is the aggregate containing both fine and coarse aggregate. Okay, that is the combination of fine and coarse aggregate, we can call it as the all-in-one aggregates. Okay, so here we can see that this is a fine aggregate and this is the coarse aggregates. Okay, next is the according to the shape of aggregate. So according to the shape of aggregates, the aggregates are classified as rounded aggregate, irregular aggregate, that is partially rounded, angular and flaky aggregate. Okay, the shape of the aggregate is important characteristic, okay, since it affects the workability of concrete and strength also. Not only the characteristic of parent rock but also the type of crusher used will influence the shape of aggregate. So this shape of aggregate is more important in coarse aggregate than fine aggregate. So first is the rounded one. So fully water worn or completely shaped by attrition, we can call as round. Okay, rounded aggregates, which we are found in the river or seashore gravels. Okay, that is desert seashore and wind blown sand. Okay, this is the example of this rounded aggregate. Next is the irregular or partially rounded aggregates. Okay, so this is the naturally irregular or partially shaped by attrition having the rounded edges. Okay, so these example of these irregular irregular shape of aggregate is pit sands and gravels and land or duck flints, that is cuboid rock. Okay, next is the angular shape aggregate. Okay, it possessing the well defined edges formed at the intersection of roughly planar faces. And example of this shape of aggregate is crushed rock, okay, that is all types, that is talus, screens, okay, which we are found in quarries, okay. Next is flaky one, okay. Material generally used angular of which the thickness is small relative to the width and the length, okay. Flaky means it having the thickness or width is less, very relatively very small as compared to the its length. And the example of this is laminated rocks. So this is the first rounded rock, okay, rounded shape aggregate. This is irregular or partially rounded aggregates, okay. This is angular aggregates, okay. We are generally using this angular aggregate for the concrete, okay, because it gives a good interlocking, okay, and also the rough texture, okay. So the bond between the cement paste and this aggregate is much what we can say, much good as compared to the rounded aggregate, okay. And this is the flaky one, flaky aggregates, okay. This is the elongated aggregate and this is the flaky aggregate, okay. So this is all about the today's lecture. Hope you will understand the today's all points. So thank you.